I found this thumbnail in my YouTube feed this morning. Have a go at it and let me know how it goes. If you found that easy, you might want to try this one. Looks scarier, right? And when are we ever going to use this stuff anyway? You could guess at this problem and have 50% odds of getting it right. So why would Cambridge ask a question that half of the candidates are going to get right just by guessing? And it does seem easy if you go about it right. That's if you go about it right. The plot thickens, and there is something wrong with this approach. So let's throw some calculus at it. This is our function. Let's take its derivative and see if we can find a critical point. Here's the first derivative. Pretty impressive, right? We can find a zero of this function just by examining this one factor. And it turns out that this point is a critical point, but we don't know if it's a maximum, a minimum, or an inflection. So we would have to take the second derivative to do that, and let's not. It turns out that it's a maximum, and you can check that on your own if you like. It turns out now that our scarier problem is actually a piece of cake. We know that the function is decreasing between x equals 100 and x equals 101. However, none of the highfalutin calculus gets us anywhere because x equals 2 and x equals 3 straddles that maximum point. And we don't really know enough about the shape of the function to know which one of these is larger. And this is where high school math comes to the rescue. No calculus required. Pretty straightforward, isn't it? So are the folks at Cambridge really testing math skills with this question, or are they interested in creativity? And sadly, creativity isn't on the menu in many high school math courses. Precious little time is devoted to struggling with a problem. Yet it's that struggle that teaches creative problem solving, which everyone needs in the real world. Here's another puzzle for you to try out, and thanks for watching. Cheers.